Hi traders, here's a new video. First of all, the risk warning, your invested capital may be at risk. Don't trade with money you cannot afford to lose, and this video is not investment advice. So this video is another candlestick chart analysis video. I'm going to show you how I choose my trading setup and on what I base my trading setups, why I do some trades, why I not do some trades, and how I read the candlesticks. All my trades are based on those things which I have explained in my ebook. So get this ebook, it's for free. You'll find the link in the description. This ebook contains the most important candlestick pattern, chart pattern, and binary option turbo trading concepts, but those concepts can be applied also to forex and digital options and any other kind of financial instrument. Also to any kind of expiration time and any kind of time frame. So that is price action. And in the description, you will find not only a link to the ebook, you will find also the link to the Facebook group. Join the Facebook group. Don't miss this opportunity, because there you get really a lot of nice information. So let me see what is going on here. We have here some kind of ranging area, yes, which is not so nice. The candlesticks are looking also really bad here. So I would say that is not a nice market. I will do only one trade here to show you how I trade this kind of market, and then I would show you where and what kind of trades I would do. So let's look at this. We get here some kind of hammer. Yes, this is a hammer, a bearish hammer, and after such kind of bearish hammer, I'm preparing to do a put. Yes, I'm going to do a put now. The rejection was above, yes, but I'm putting, you see, and now it's going down because I was pretty much sure that price will go down further, yes. I waited to get the best possible entry point. That was the best possible entry point for me, in my opinion, and that's the reason why I have done a put, because I was expecting that price will go down, because this hammer here was a trend continuation, in my opinion, yes, and I tried to get the best possible entry point. That is what how I do my candlestick analysis. That is why I entered into this trade. Also, on this kind of hammer, I would have done the same trade in this kind of ranging market. I would enter here above. I waited till price would shoot up, and because I would expect that the price will go down here on the last few seconds of the expiration time, I would enter here into a put. So let me see if I can show you now some trades based off those things which I have explained in the ebook, and which I'm doing almost explaining in every kind of my other videos which I'm doing. Yes, I can only tell you that you have to study those kind of that you have to study or those things which I have explained in the ebook. Try to practice those things which I have explained in the ebook, and try almost to get one of the best entry points which you can get. And if you don't get any kind of good entry point, don't do that trade. Yes, I have done this trade also only because I was above every EMA. You see here, we are here in between now, and that is almost a risky area, because you don't know if one of those EMAs here is acting now as support and resistance. Here I understood this because of the reversal. Yes, from the one deviation, I understood that we are heaving down. But in such kind of market, you have to be really careful. Yes, I would personally not do so many trades in such a kind of market, because you see here how it's ranging, and you don't know in what kind of direction market will lead. Yes, it's a overall uptrend. You see this from the EMAs, yes, but you see in between we have here a lot of consolidation areas, and also this kind of hammer here doesn't work out, yes, because it was only at the beginning, yes, and after this one it doesn't work out, but this one here was a continuation of this. And this reversal here doesn't work out here, because it should go up further, but it doesn't got higher. So I was pretty much sure that price will go down further, yes. And after this, I would not do any kind of trade here in this kind of area, because I'm not sure what will happen. You see how price is moving up and down, yes. So I would not even do here a spinning top trade, yes, but it's looking like here we get a neckline, so I will do a call here. Yes, I'm going to do a call now because I waited for a good entry point, and now I'm pretty much sure that price will go up further because we have here a double bottom, yes, and this double bottom with the neckline at this level here, yes. You see, this is where the spinning top was the neckline of this double bottom, and that's the reason why I did a call, because we are here all above all EMAs, yes, that was the reason why I did this call, yes. You have to understand this. If you have some kind of ranging market, trade only at the edges, yes, of the Bollinger Band or above or below every kind of EMA. That is what I'm telling you all the time, and I hope you understand this. So let me see if I can show you now some trades which I would do here. After this one, yes, okay, that was nice in the money. So let me see here. So I would do in this kind of area, I would, first of all, I would avoid this kind of area here, yes. And I would probably doing this kind of call here, yes, after this engulfing candle. And you see, it's almost the same. Okay, I will mark, first of all, the engulfing candle. I would trade this engulfing candle, after this engulfing candle, I would trade after this engulfing candle, yes. And then I would do call here, call two after this kind of inverted hammer, yes, I would do this call, and that would be, and I have done this here because this was for me a sign that the downtrend will continue. It was so close to the 20 EMA, the 20 EMA was already flat, and so I expected that price will break through this area, yes. And here, because this one here was this double top bottom, yes, which I expected that it will unfold because we are in an uptrend. So here I would trade this kind like I have told you, and I would trade also this kind of candle and this one here after that too, and the price would get back a rejection from this level. I would do this trade too. We have here a round number, this level is a round number, and that would be also the reason why I would do this kind of call here. This is a nice trade here. This is something like a I don't know how it's called, yes, but you see it reject from this level here again after two candles. That is really nice. That's a trade which I like to do almost often. So the other ones I would not trade, not even this one here, because here it would be not clear if the trend will continue, because we are here in some Bollinger squeeze. You see here Bollinger squeeze, and that is not nice because a breakout can happen at any point. Here also the breakout, here happens the breakout after, yes, but it could be happening also here at this level, yes. So I would not enter into this trade because we didn't touch the Bollinger Band, and that was only on the one deviation, and you see it got here a reversal, and then it got the breakout, yes, instead of breaking out here. That is a tricky, yes, so I would not do this kind of trade. So let me see. So let me see what we have here. So here the market is looking a little bit better, yes, but you see also here, and that is what I am explaining often, Bollinger squeeze, yes, and you see immediately here after the Bollinger squeeze, here there is a consolidation area, yes, and this engulfing candle with hammer, bearish hammer, is not unfolding right, yes, and that is the tricky part. If you see that the Bollinger Band is squeezing, stay away, yes, from any kind of candlestick analysis videos, yes, not candlestick analysis or candlestick behaviors, yes, because you see market is doing his own thing on this kind of market. So I would do this kind of call here after this reversal. Here we have a nice downtrend, and after this nice downtrend was the reversal. So I would do this kind of trade like I have explained before. So then here in this kind there would be a pullback. Maybe I would do this kind of call here because we are in uptrend, and that is nothing else than the 20 EMA pullback. Then we get here this this engulfing candle, and so I would trade this kind of candle here for sure, yes. And after this here, the shooting star. Here we have a nice shooting star, which shows me that the next candle could be a red one. Yes, and I would enter, but I would try to enter above this level here, because you see we have the 20 EMA, which is almost flat, but still can be a rejection from, yes, and so I would trade it only on the rejection and trying to get as soon as possible into this trade. So I would trade this kind of candle here as a continuation, because we are here in between of the one deviation and two deviation Bollinger Band, and that would be a nice continuation pattern here, which would tell me after this retracement, because if you get a retracement, and if you get a retracement, and this is an engulfing candle, this is a clear call here, this candlestick, because you know a retracement was already done, then you get this kind of candlestick, so you know that the trend will continue. And that is the reason why you can enter easily in this kind of trade. On the rejection from this round number here, yes, you could also do this kind of trade after this Mauro Boso candlestick, yes, because you could expect that the trend will continue too. Yes, you see here also this kind of area, and if price would break through this, I would wait that it would came back to this level here, yes, and then I would enter again into this kind of trade, because price would go back to this level, because there is a round number which will act as support and resistance level. So here in this kind of area, I would probably doing this kind of trade here after this one here, because we have here a long wick, yes, and if you have a long wick, you know mostly, and I have explained this also a lot of times in a lot of videos, the pressure will come from above to below, from the selling pressure, yes, because we have this long wick, and so I would enter into this kind of trade. And this is also looking a little bit here like an exhaustion candle, that there is the trend is ending. We got a rejection from the round number, and that is what I would expect here. So let me see if I can show you also here some trades, then I will finish this video. So let me see. Here we get an engulfing candle, but we have here a consolidation area, yes? But the consolidation area takes long place here, long place. Here is no trades to do, because we are here also close to the EMAs. Here is everything not so clear. Here we get some kind of Bollinger squeeze, yes? The point where you could enter into a trade is after this engulfing candle, in this kind of trade here, of this candle. And then I would say here I would do probably only this kind of trade here, because here we are above all EMAs and we have space to the one deviation Bollinger Band and also to the two deviation Bollinger Band, and that would be okay. The other ones will not be, and this one I have shown you already, yes. Or you can do also this kind of trade here, but this is no rejection, so I would try to avoid this because it could go down further, yes, because you don't know what will happen if price will get again against this kind of EMA. The thing is, what you see here is a nice 20 EMA pullback, which you can trade really nice again with Forex, yes, after this kind of squeezing and ranging. You get here a nice movement, and if you expect or if you compare this with 1 hour candlestick pattern or 4 hour candlestick chart, yes, you would understand that this would be a nice 1 or 2 day rally, yeah, yeah, where price will go up, 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 and that would be nice profit. So I would say that would be enough. If you like this video, do a like. If you didn't subscribe, subscribe. And if you have something to say, let me say a comment or join the Facebook group. Don't miss this opportunity. So I would say stay safe and bye-bye.